Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. All right. We're going to be real short today. I got a short word today. God showed me that I could reach more with short messages than I can the long ones. That's a word to a lot of the pastors. You know, I'm telling you, people's attention span is not long these days. But I do want to thank God for all of you in the house, Holy House family. Thank God. I love y'all. I got a great group of people here. Let's give your own self a praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I told you I would do this. Our own Pastor Margie is back. Amen. She came back last night. So let's give her a hand praise. Amen. Amen. We're so glad to have you back, Pastor Martin. And I was saying that on behalf of those on Facebook, been asking me when she's coming back. Well, she's here. And we thank God for her. Amen. And we thank also the God for my daughter and son-in-law who's on the road heading back to Houston. They the one brought her back. And we hope that y'all have a safe trip. If y'all watching in this morning, that y'all have a safe trip. Okay? Amen. God is so good, man. Oh, he's so good. Hallelujah. I'm going to stand as long as I could on these legs. And amen. But y'all pray for the bishop. But anyway, Facebook, I'm going to tell y'all something. I love y'all. I got a lot of Facebook friends. I want to tell you that I probably won't be on Facebook much after today. And it's for no special reason other than I want to concentrate in my ministry more. Facebook been taking up too much of my time in ministry. So if y'all don't see me on there, it's nothing personal, and I ain't mad with anybody. It's just that I'm trying to concentrate myself more in ministry. Amen. Now I come in on there every now and then to say how you doing or something, or give you a scripture, or I say happy birthday to you if you got a birthday or something. However, if you want to contact me, call me through Messenger. I'll return you a message back. I check my Messenger every day. Y'all can contact me. Thank you, brother. Hope they heard that part.
Testing. Good. So, I'll repeat it in case you didn't hear it. Now, I won't be on Facebook a lot because I'm concentrating in ministry. And it has nothing to do with you all on Facebook. But God told me it's time to concentrate. Sometimes I have been into too much foolish talking and jesting on there. And God told me, so, all right, Bishop, it's time to back up. This is serious business you in. Got time for no lollygagging on that.
I heard that.
When I heard the voice of God, I had to back up. So, when y'all don't see me, it's no offense. I still love y'all. Even to the ones that I hadn't talked to in a while, I hadn't saw you. I love y'all. Okay? And if you ever want to contact me, get on Messenger, and I will return your message. Amen. So let's go to the word. I don't want to be long. I want to be real short. Some of y'all might not like this message, though. But I have to do what God told me to do. Hallelujah. And I'm going to give y'all some scriptures. And those on Facebook, you want to write some scriptures down and study it for yourself so you'll know that I ain't making this up. I'm going to give y'all some scriptures, and some going to be read. I'm going to give y'all the scripture that's going to read for me. I want you to write it down so you won't have to turn to it, because sometimes when you have to look for it, you hold the service up. So I'm going to give you your scriptures for the read. And Sister Margie, I'm going to start with you. And I'll let you know when I want it read, okay? But I want you to go to Acts 5. Just have it already over there when I call you. Acts chapter 5, verse 38 and 39. Okay? All right. Brother Keith, I need you to read 1 Thessalonians 4 and 8.
Amen.
All right. Brother Marcus, you're on the computer. Could you read one? All right. I want you to read 1 Corinthians 8 and 12. God told me to start going more to the scriptures when I preach, so y'all won't think it's being made up. So y'all got your scriptures? Okay, have it already. I'm gonna call you when I get ready. Well, the title of the message today is called Quit Fighting with God. That's the title of the message. Quit fighting with God. Now somebody say, well, Bishop, I don't fight God. I wouldn't do that. I couldn't win anyway, so I wouldn't fight God. Well, I stopped by this morning to tell you there are other ways that you could fight God and you don't even know you're fighting him. Y'all better hear me today.
That's right.
You could fight God and not know it. In the natural, everything looking okay. But in the spirit realm, you are out of order. I'm just going to give you a few ways to recognize that you are fighting God. I'm going to tell you a few ways. And if you got your pen and paper, write this down. Number one, when we fight each other, you fighting God.
That's right.
Amen.
Oh, well.
And the scriptures for that is, whatever you do to the least of my people, you're doing it to me. Ain't that right? Look what it said, the least of my people. That means people who just got saved. People who ain't been in this thing very long. People who make mistakes. People who come short. He said, when you cut them down, guess what? You cutting me down too. Y'all don't want to say nothing. Hello, somebody. You fighting God by fighting each other. Look what Jesus told the Pharisee. He said, well, if y'all don't receive me, you can't receive the one that sent me.
Come on now.
Because we won. When you fight God and tear down your brothers and sisters, you fighting God if it, or have them to read the scriptures shortly.
Come on.
But look here, when you fight, let me tell you what it's like. It's like a woman would be walking down the street with her baby. And a man see the mama and the baby walking together. And the man say, ooh, that sure is an ugly baby. Ooh. Well, when you say that, you ain't just attacked the baby. You didn't attack the mama. Because he came from her.
All right now.
Am I making any sense? You didn't insult her too. And that's the way it is about God. When you talk about his people, you didn't insult God. Hello.
That's right.
He said, you mess, look what God said. Jesus said that. He said, it's better that you put a millstone around your neck and jump out into the sea and drown yourself than to be messing with God's people.
Come on now.
I'm telling you what God said. He don't like nobody messing with his folks.
Come on.
Because when you mess with his folk, what? You're messing with him.
That's right.
That's what I'm saying. You could be fighting God by. That's why God told me I'm going to show you a scripture for it first. Sister Robin, you got 1 Thessalonians?
No.
Who got 1 Thessalonians? Oh, huh?
I do.
1 Thessalonians 4:8 first then.
Yeah.
Okay. Watch this, what going to be read. Don't listen to what people are saying. Listen to what the word's saying. Some of us live by what people say, and you think you're all right. But man, you need to listen to what the Bible say. Amen. Some people are people pleasers. Man, I don't care how popular something is and everybody doing it and it's popular, it don't mean it's right. It might be okay in the natural realm, but when you get in the spiritual realm, God says, that ain't me. That's much out of order. Hallelujah. There's a way that seemeth right, but the end of those things are death. Read 1 Thessalonians 4:8. Look what it say.
Therefore, he who rejoices.
Come on, read loud.
Therefore, he who rejects this does not reject man, but God, who has also given us his Holy Spirit.
That, I hear some static in your mic. I need somebody with one that can read real loud.
Therefore, he who rejects this does not reject man, but God, who has also given us his Holy Spirit.
Wait a minute, that first part though, did you hear that?
Yeah.
He that despised man is not despising man, but God.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
You're not despised. You see it in the word.
Yes,
he said, when you despise a person, you're not. You might look like you're despising just that person, but you're despising God.
Yeah.
Read it again. You don't need no mic. You got a hidden mic down up in you.
Therefore, he who rejects this does not reject man, but God, who has also given us his Holy Spirit.
What? You writing, that's an English translation?
New King James.
Somebody got King James, read it loud for me. Yeah, yes, ma'am.
He therefore that despises not man, but God, who hath also given unto us his Spirit.
He that despises.
Yes, sir.
Okay, y'all heard that, didn't you? You despise a person, you're in danger of the judgment. Now, somebody asked me what despise mean. Now, I want you to listen to this very carefully. Very carefully, y'all. Amen. Watch this. Despising mean when you don't like a person, a strong dislike for a person.
That's right.
Yeah.
Amen. And there's a lot of people say that, talking about, well, I don't hate them, I just don't like them. Do you know that's a dangerous statement to make? Yeah. I've made it myself, but I had to do research. That is very dangerous to say that.
Oh,
if anything, if you all, amen, because it's a thin line, amen. That song says a thin line between love and hate. But in this case, it's a thin line between despising and hating, or not liking a person and hating them. You're too close to the line. You might not like that person, but you're too close to the line. Hello, something. You need to back up. If anything, this is what you ought to say. If you don't like a person, this is what you ought to do. Listen to me good. Just say, I just don't follow their ways. Their ways, I don't always agree with their ways, or their character is not always becoming with me, but I don't dislike them, you know, as a person. See, you have to separate the person from the ugly ways. From the character. Yeah, you got to separate. Just like sin. You got to separate the sin from the person. You got to still love them when you see them in Walmart. Yeah. Hello, somebody. You might not favor them because they got ugly ways, but you better not, don't go around saying that I don't like them. Because if you despise man, what did I tell you? You are despising God, who gave us his Holy Spirit. Man made in the image and the likeness of God. You are coming against him. I don't like that. All right? Marcus, 1 Corinthians 8 and 12. Listen to this one now. I'm showing you how you fight God.
But when ye sin so against the brethren, or wound their weak conscience, ye sinned against Christ.
Oh, you heard that? When you sin against your brother, weak brothers too, guess what? What happens, Marcus, when I sin against my weak brother?
Ye sin against Christ.
You fighting God. You fighting Christ. Man, it's almost equivalent to say, Lord, I'm going to throw a rock at you. You fighting God by fighting your brother. That's why the Lord told me to take my mouth off of people and their ministers. And that brings me to Acts 5, 38 and 39. And that's Sister Margie.
And now I say unto you, refrain from these men and let them alone. But if this counsel or this word be of men, it will come to naught.
Mm-hmm.
But if God be, but if it be of God, ye cannot overthrow it.
Come on.
Least happily ye be found even to fight against God.
You heard that?
Yes, sir.
You fighting against God. When you come against people ministering, if God is working through that ministry, guess what? You fighting God.
Yeah.
Amen. Didn't you just read that, Sister Robin? He said, if lest we be found happily fighting against God. He said, let these men ministry alone.
Yes,
sir. That's why I'm trying to take my mouth off of people ministry, because I don't know how God is working in it.
That's right. That's it.
Y'all don't want to say nothing. Sometimes, amen, God worked through a lot of different type of ministry.
Yeah.
Hello. I used to fight different ministers, like the Baptist church. I said, they ain't got nothing. The Methodist people, I said, they dead. Dead spirit up in that church. And the Lord told me, say, Bishop, quit that. You stop doing that because you don't know how I'm working through these ministers. Quit putting folk down. Hello. And you didn't seem to forget that you got saved in the Baptist church. And I sure did. I got saved under the Baptist ministry. That was a step my stepping stone to where I am now. Methodist people, I've learned a lot about order and a lot of other different things through the Methodist people. Yep. Amen. So God said, don't burn them bridges that helped bring you over. That was me use those bridges to get you over. And the same God can bring other people over. Oh, they might not be where you want them to be at, but let them alone. I'm moving through that. Yeah. Hello, somebody. I don't even criticize the Jehovah's Witness no more, because people that got saved through stuff like that, man. And we throwing bricks. And God said, you don't know my purpose, what I'm trying to do. Woo. I have to use all of this to reach certain people, man.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. You fighting me. Get your hand off of me. Mm-hmm. And grab me in the collar. Mm-hmm. Hello, somebody.
That's right.
You fight against the brethren, you're fighting against me. Ain't that what you just read, preacher?
That's right.
You're fitting the brethren. You messing with me too. Mm-hmm. Quit fighting God. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. It's time for us to, I told Pastor Campbell I was going to bring up something he said Sunday. He really blessed me. I look at his program on Sunday evening, and he said something that was a blessing to me. He said this. He said, be careful how we call people false prophets and false. Mm-hmm. Everybody ain't false.
Come on now.
Everybody's not a false prophet just because he prophesied and he missed. Yeah. Amen. Sometimes people miss. Why? Because this is a growth process. We ain't there yet. Some of our teachings be a little off.
Yeah.
But as we grow, we're getting better in it.
Yeah.
Them still God's people.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
I know when I first started, I was prophesying wild, man. I was saying everything. Oh, wow, the way out in left field kind of prophet. Wasn't even nearly close. But I was trying to do God's will. I loved it, God, and God loved it me. And look where he at. He didn't brought me thus far.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
What if people would have kicked me out the ministry and said, you didn't get out because you didn't miss. You was a false prophet.
Yeah.
I probably missed the prophecy, but I just wasn't there yet. Mm-hmm. Some of you not there yet.
That's it.
Ain't none of us there yet.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What the Bible say, we all know in part. And when that is complete, it's completed, we'll know it full. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Yeah. Let's quit cutting each other down.
That's right.
Take your mouth off of each other.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Good God Almighty. I used to be fighting women preachers and all of that. I said, them women need to sit down until God taught me better.
That's right.
Uh-huh. And I had to come back and apologize to my wife and all of other ministers and evangelists that I had been tearing down. Mm-hmm. I was fighting God. Some ministers still fighting them. God said, didn't I tell y'all old crazy ministers that I'm going to pull my spirit out on all flesh, your sons and daughters. Daughters is a woman, ain't it? Hallelujah. I'm going to pull my spirit up on all flesh. And they're going to prophesy. They're going to minister this word. But we weren't there yet, you see. Hallelujah. So let's quit fighting each other. In so doing, fighting God. Let's move on. That energy you using to tear down a brother, we brother or sister, use it to encourage and build up. Say, brother, God bless you. I'm still praying for you. God, I'm going to take you up. You're going to get there. You watch what I tell you. You're going to get there. Don't say nothing bad about it. They might be just a scripture like two left shoes, but keep on giving them encouragement. Say, you're going to get there, brother. Keep on praying. I'm praying for you, too. We all traveling the same road.
We're
going to help each other along the way.
Yes.
Come on, man. Don't demean their character, people character. Don't cut down their past or use past against people. You don't want nobody doing you like that. Hello, somebody. Let's not belittle people like I'm way up here and you way down there. Ain't no big eyes we'll use here. Come on. God loves us all. Some of those folk gonna still get to heaven. They got all kind of people in God's net. They got weak people, if you don't believe it. 14th chapter of Romans, read the 14th chapter of Romans, verse 1, 2, and 3. He said, they are weak brothers. He said, when you find a weak brother or sister in Christ, he said, receive them, didn't he? He said, receive such a one.
Yes,
and then you read down a few verses, God, he said, because God has received them. In other words, them my people. I don't care if he is weak. And then in another chapter, he said, comfort the feeble-minded. It's going to be some feeble-minded people can't learn on like you learn. And then he said, comfort the weak. and the finger minded. So therefore, we're going to have all kind in the net. But you got to be God's people. They love God. Hello? Amen. Amen. They might not be strong, but this race ain't just for the strong.
Come on.
Or for the swift. But it's to him who can endure to the end. He didn't say you have to be strong all the time.
Uh-huh.
You're going to get weak sometimes.
Yeah.
Some ain't going to learn fast as others. But they're God's people.
Yeah.
I think about the poor thief on the cross. He didn't know a lot about Jesus. Otherwise, he wouldn't have been stealing like he was.
That's right. That's
what they were killing him for. He was a thief. But he got had enough about Jesus. Know the little bit about Jesus. Say, Lord, remember me. Come on, somebody. And the Lord saved him at the last minute. God got all these deals with people according to their levels. And some people's level is one way and another level might be higher, but that don't make you better than that person. Hello, somebody. We are all one in Christ. To some he give a little, and to some he give a lot. But to much is given, much is required. For them that be faithful over least.
Preach, preacher.
Good God Almighty. I'm gonna make them rule over much because they were faithful over just a little I gave them. It ain't you no way they got much. God gave you that just to see where you at. And them that got least, he gave you that too. Just to see where everybody is. Some people get the big head because they got a little more. Hey, just because they got a few more members than the ugly. Amen. Amen. We anointed. Amen. You're going to be just like that church in Revelation. It said them people was rich. They had wealth. They had nice stuff out in front of the church. The chariots, whatever they got. I don't know if they had cars back then. I doubt it. But they had chariots all out there in front of the church. And look here. Look what God sent the angel by to tell them people. Man, they was wealthy. They was well-to-do. God said, tell them people there at that church. He said, y'all think you rich. You think you wealthy. You think that you got more God than anybody else because you got all of this stuff. Y'all hear me? He said, but you don't know you naked and blind and wretched. Come on now. Ain't got the word. He said, y'all need to rub your eyes with ourselves. Your riches don't make you better with me. I gave you that to see what you'll do with it. I gave it to the rich man. Hallelujah, to see what he'll do with it. He didn't even feed Lazarus the crumbs off his table. Now look where he at. He in that hellfire.
Yeah.
Whatever you have, God gave it to you. Whatever level you on, God got you there. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. Don't put each other down. When you do, you're talking against God. God said, don't get in my purpose.
Come on,
this is
now.
My purpose.
Yes, sir.
Let the purpose flow like it's supposed to flow.
Mm-hmm.
Can I get with me?
Amen.
We want to grow it like we want to grow it. Them Baptists, they need to speak in tongues. Let them folks alone. They know Jesus Christ. Hello. Number two, I'm going to close at number three. Believe it or not, I'm coming on. Number two, and I'm going to be quick with number two, is when you don't do your assignment that God gives you.
All right.
You fighting God. You might as well took a brick and throw it at God. Hallelujah. You might as well go grab God in the collar. You fighting him when he didn't give you a sign, but I'm going to give you a scripture for it too. Hey, look, don't do that. We might have been getting by with it, but we ain't getting away. That's guess what? We got to stand before judgment. How many know we got to stand before judgment? That's where you're going to really be nervous. Jesus said you're going to be shaking, you're going to be crying, it's going to be some gnashing of teeth. You may get by, but you don't get away. You're going to answer for everything done in your body, whether they be good or evil. So I'm warning you. Don't say the preacher didn't warn you. Amen. Now watch this. When God gave you a sign, why didn't you do what I asked you to do? Hello? And the scripture I want to give you, and y'all already know about it, is Jonah. You can start with the first chapter. You go home and read the whole first chapter of Jonah. Watch this. He sent Jonah to Nineveh. But he said, I'm going to Tarshish. And you know what that's like? That's how you think about you, God. You say, he said that your actions are saying it. Sometimes actions speak louder than words. Jonah, go to Nineveh. He went where he wanted to win. That offends God when you don't do what he told you to do. Can I get a witness? That offends him. And you could tell God was upset. Look what happened to that storm. He sent that storm down through there. Hallelujah. Just like Hurricane Katrina, praise God. Came. It was just like that. It came through there and turned that ship over with Jonah on there. And he got the message then. that God do not play. Hello, don't let him turn your ship over, because you won't do what he tell you. Hello, somebody. Some of us, God did put some good singing down in you. Amen. Some of you know you got some good voices. Brother Marcus needs you in the praise team. But we won't move on them good gifts. We can sing. And God said, you, that gift I gave you. That's what I gave it to you for.
Come on,
you know what we'll do? So I'm going to sit right now. I ain't doing nothing. Doing just like Jonah. I ain't doing nothing.
Come on now.
God said, but that's what I get. I ain't doing nothing. You keep on.
That's right.
Amen. Listen, whatever God gave you, he gave it to you to use it for his glory. When you say you ain't going to do it, you fighting God.
Amen.
Am I making any sense?
Right.
Now, the funny thing about it, Brookie, when they go home, they sing all in the mirror. They sound good, too. Man, I said, that must sound like the William Brothers or somebody up in there. Man, they can sing good at home, but then come home, come to church, look, and sit down on God again. God said, that's what I gave it for you to sing at church. Hello, somebody. Good God Almighty. It's time to quit fighting God. Quit insulting him. Amen. Amen. Look. God Almighty. When he gives you an assignment, do it. I'm going to show you something else. Don't even poke that lip out when God tell you to do something. Then poke your lip out at God. I remember back in, you like a kid when the mama said, go in there and wash them dishes. Boy, I remember the day you get that lip knocked out too. He bust that lip. Boy, y'all blessed in the young generation. Boy, I tell you, back then, you poke that lip out if you want. But we do God like that. God just sent us to do some assignments, and we just don't want to do it. Then put the lip out. God said, I'm getting tired now. I didn't bless you to be like that. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's get on here. Now, some people got assignment. This might surprise some of you. Amen. I'm standing as long as I could. Old leg trembling, boy. That's all right. I could have been set down, but I had to throw this at the devil and let it know. I'm going for the time.
Come on now.
That was that represent. Hallelujah. Watch this. Some of y'all might not understand this, what I'm going to say. I'm about 75, almost 82%. Some people, marriage is their assignment. Now, what I mean by that, I want you to listen carefully. Some people got spouses that ain't all the way there yet. Man, they just full of hell. They raise sand. They don't want to go to church. They don't want to. Hey, they give you trouble at home. And you ask yourself, say, how did I get wrapped up in this? Lord, what was I thinking about? But you know what God say? Look what God say. He said, I don't want to put y'all together. Because for a reason, I wanted you to, this is your assignment. I want you to get that person saved. I'm going to work through you to get them delivered like I did Hosea.
That's
and
right.
With his wife, Gomer. I had to work through Hosea to get to Gomer. Y'all over here, it ain't about you no more. Tell me, what about my feeling? It ain't about your feeling. You were sold out when God bought you. You don't own yourself no more. Your emotions, amen, and all that, that belongs to God. So sometimes God will say, kill that part of you right now, and then get your spouse saved. If you do that one assignment, that's good. That might get you right on in the kingdom because you obeyed me. Hallelujah. That's what happened to Abraham. Abraham did that one assignment, didn't he? He put his son Isaac on the altar. Hallelujah. And when God saw how faithful he was, he said, Abraham, stop. He told the angel to stop that knife from killing his son. And he told him, say, man, since you were that faithful, let me tell you something. You did the assignment I asked you to do. You're going to be the father of many nations. Oh, yeah. In other words, it didn't matter what Abraham did from there on. He impressed God for his assignment so good that God told him, you're going to be the father of many nations. He was called the friend of God from that point on. Let me tell you, whatever your assignment is, hang on in there with it. Don't let the devil steal your assignment. Can I get a witness? Whatever that assignment is. If you can preach, preach. Don't be running from God like Jonah. Hallelujah. Just ask the pastor, say, let me come and do an exhortation or something, and I'll see where you're at. I'll see if you're up here clowning or trying to be seen. Hello, I know when God calls you, because I'm going to see it. Come on, somebody. But if you'll know it too, because God's going to tell you it's time. Hallelujah. Those that can sing, come on off that gift and quit sitting down on it. I like what Pastor Weems said over in New Life. He said some of us that buried that gift. It's time to go dig that gift up, hallelujah, and do what God told you. And if you don't, you just like fighting him. Come on now, dig that gift up. If you can sing at home in the mirror, you can sing at church.
That's right. Amen.
Hallelujah. I love y'all. Don't be mad with me. I'm just telling you what God told me. For the closing right now, Miss Brenda. I'm in the last point here. Hallelujah. The final point, and somebody might not like this one, but when you don't obey authority or leadership, you fighting against God. Hello, somebody. Some of us have been doing that for a long time. Hallelujah. But it's time out to quit fighting these leaders. And the scripture for that is in Romans 13 chapter, verse 1. Read it. Read it when you go home. 13 chapter, verse 1. He said, submit yourself to authority. He said, there's no powers except the powers that I've ordained. In other words, what God done ordained, don't you fight it. Can I get a witness? All right. Hebrews 13 chapter, verse 17 say, obey them who have rule over you. That's what God said. I didn't say it. Hallelujah. I don't care if it's this church or any church. Some people, man, don't want to listen to authority. Some people don't want to do right. Oh, y'all don't hear me. They don't want nobody to say nothing to them. Hallelujah. And one lady told me that too. She said, Bishop, I come to church for the word. I don't come for all these rules and regulations. I just want to hear the word. I know what I told her. I said, that is the word, sister. Submit yourself to all authority, because there's no powers except the powers of God. Submit to these pastors. Praise God. Behold, I send you pastors after my own heart, and they're going to feed you with wisdom and knowledge. You obey them, says the Lord. For when you don't obey them, you frighten me. It's just like you didn't hit me, too. When you hit any one of my children, you didn't hit me. Come on now, we got to listen to authority. And some of us is just as rebellious as hell. Man, and hell is not a bad word. Hallelujah. You can't say nothing to some people. I'm about to get out of here now, devil. But listen, you take one thing to somebody, hallelujah, and they don't like it. They didn't left the church because they don't like you telling them nothing. Say one thing to their children, they gone. The children, poor little children running all around the church, and all you did is correcting it. They'll leave the church and say they church hurt. Ain't no church hurt. You don't want to listen to nobody. That's all that is. You disobedient. That's what he told Ezekiel. He said, these people is hard, disobedient people. Don't even pray for them because they disobedient. They don't want to listen to authority. And that's going on right now today. Man, they don't want to listen to this mess. Man, I tell you, listen, I'm telling you right now. It's time to listen to what these pastors telling you. The Bible says in Hebrews 10:28. Say they that despised in Moses' laws died without mercy. Oh, y'all don't hear me. I'm telling you the Bible. Read it yourself. Hebrews 10:28. Say they died without mercy because they wouldn't obey Moses. Watch this. The last one I want to tell you about is Korah. Korah, praise God, was a man that revolted against Moses. Amen. He got him 120 men. Against Moses. You know why? Because they didn't like the way Moses was running things. And you know how people live. They can't have it their way. They think it's Burger King. They can't have it their way. They gone. Hey! Good God Almighty. They didn't like the way Moses was running it. And so he got them 120 members, and they're going to rise up against Moses. Tell me, we don't like the way you doing things. Listen, and they just kept fighting Moses over and over. Finally, watch this. God got mad. Oh, it's a terrible thing to get God mad. Yeah. Oh, my God, my God. God saw what they were doing to Moses, and he said, Moses, get out the way now. And he still was trying to pray for him, not to kill him. But he said, Moses, this ain't got nothing to do with you no more. Move out the way, lest you be also destroyed. Read your Bible. God almost took Moses out with him, too, if he'd have got in the way. He said, this fight is between me and them. Man, Korah and them was out there acting a fool. Pray God, God opened the ground up. And then swallowed them under the ground. Man, fire came up out the ground. You know what that fire represented? It represented them folk went straight to hell. God was the judge, the executioner, and everybody. The jury, God just said, well, I ain't going to go through with all that. They going to hell immediately. That ground opened up. Why did it open up and kill them people? Because they was fighting against a leader. I'm telling you, y'all, don't come fighting against leaders. Do what they tell you to do if it ain't nothing wrong with it. Do what they say, pray God. Because in so doing, you're obeying God. I wish I had a witness here. I'm closing now. Closing my thing. But I want to give this last testimony about a lady used to come here. Man, that lady gave me hell. Hallelujah. It gave me the blues. Hell is in the Bible. Don't go around these sanctimonious folks talking about he cuss. And I ain't cuss. That's in the Bible.
That's right.
That's right. Hey! But you know what? This lady gave me the blues, if that make you feel anything. Man, she come in here with me. Every time I would ask her to do something, good God Almighty, I ain't got time. Amen. I said, well, church gonna have a meeting here. We gonna do some something for Saturday. I want all the people to meet. I ain't coming. And I told my sister I already had something to do, and we gonna do that. I said, okay. But look like every time I ask your sister, you got something to do.
Well,
when you gonna obey this leadership and do something for your church sometime? Man, she gave me the blues, y'all. And what made me so mad, she'll stir up the other people too. Get them all mad at me. Hallelujah. And then this the one, the straw that broke the camel's back right here. Watch this. She would take her little $20 or $30 that she paid tithes with. Like, that's a lot of money. And try to control the church. She'll stir up the rest of the members. Where's our money going? I thought by now we'd have a concrete driveway out there. By now, parking lot. Me and some of the members talked about it, Bishop, and we don't see no progress. Where's our money going? Man, I got really mad. Man, that lady made me. I got just like God told Moses to get back out the way. That's where God. Listen, I got so mad. I told her I had to call her to herself. I'm finna close. I called her to herself one day. I said, sister, come in. I don't mean no harm. Let me talk to you, man. Listen, when you put your money in this church, it ain't your money no more. First of all, the money goes to God. If you paid your tithes and offering, the first fruits to God, it belongs to God. It ain't yours. Did you release the money? You got to give and release it to God. If it's still yours, you can't get blessed. Am I making sense? It's still yours. God said, you know, praying who? Me, your tithes in the storehouse. But if you still holding on, talking about my money, you in the error. You ain't, it's just like you ain't paid no tithe. And the second thing wrong with that, what you said, I told her this too. I say, when this money hit this basket, it belonged to the Holy House of God. It's in jurisdiction of Holy House of God. And from that point on, it's up to the pastor and his board, if he have a board, which way the money goes. Hello, somebody. It ain't none of your business. Come on now. I had to get that lady straight, man. She eventually left the church. And I was glad. Maybe I was not saying this, but man, sometimes I was praying that she leave. Some people you have to pray out to your church. Y'all don't want to hear me today. I'll let her be somebody else headache, but man, I was glad. But man, when... Don't do that. Don't fight these leaders like that. Come on now. I'm closing. I'm going to pray for us that have been doing that. And that little money that she had been given wanted to make a mess, big mess behind it. It wasn't even worth it. You know what I closed on and told her? I said, from now on, if you think your money is that important, keep it to yourself. Put it in your pocket.
Amen.
I don't want no money. I'm telling y'all that too. I don't want no money with strings attached. You can't freely give to this ministry. Put it in the bank somewhere. Don't bring that curse money in me, in here. Don't bring that witchcraft money in here. Trying to control the church. Trying to control everybody with that little money. Man, I was making it before you came. I'm going to make it when you go. God always been blessing me. He blessed me with 3 members to get this church just about. Ain't God good? Man, let's not do that. So, in my conclusion, I'm going to pray for you right now. Hallelujah. God been speaking to many of you to say, and this is what he's been saying. I want you to pray right now while I'm praying. Quit fighting me, said the Lord. You might not see it that way, but that's what it is. I've been waking some of y'all up at 4 in the morning. Wanting you to talk to me. And guess what you've been doing? Going taking sleeping pills, trying to go back to sleep. I've been trying to get your attention, and you won't even give it to me. You're fighting me. Why do you want to fight me when I'm trying to start a relationship with you? Come on now. When I get you up at 4, talk to me. You talk to Facebook, talk to me. If some of us would do to God what we do to Facebook, we'd be some strong Christians. That's why I'm coming off of that. There's too much on there, man. Too much. I know scriptures be on there. I know prayers some people write on there. But hey, that some things ain't for you. That's their prayers. That's their vision. God said, I want to talk to you individually for your scriptures. What scripture would I want to give you? Not for their script. That might be for them. Hello, somebody. I want to minister to you in the spirit. And you'd be going back to sleep. God said, I tried to help you, and you'd have gone back to sleep. Fight me then and go on to sleep. And you want that blessing, you're going to see. Now, Lord, I bless everybody here that they'll learn not to fight you. That includes myself, too. When you tell me what to do, Jesus, I'm going to try to do exactly how you told me. And them on Facebook, them that's been fighting and running from you, I pray that they get healed and open their eyes to know that you can't whoop God. You just got to surrender. And I pray that we all surrender this day in Jesus' name. And the church say, amen. Amen. I'm finished.